50 block. Let's go.
Oh, hold on, okay.
Hell yeah.
What's up, y'all? It's Big Block. SRT out here with 50 block, you know what I'm saying? Powered by SRT today, boy, with 50 block. We ain't gonna start them up, though. I ain't gonna start them up. Y'all already heard them started in the intro. So let's go on here and what we gonna do is, you got this right here. You know I say this right here, I'm country. So you gotta understand when I say this right here. You gotta know what that is. Because you come over here, oh yeah. You know what it is. Everything I do, we do it big. No, I'm just playing. But anyway, you know what it is. It's Thottle Body. I think this is 105, bro. I went stupid. You know what I'm saying? I got the whole toolbox out, too. I don't know what I'm going to need. See, I bring everything. When I come big. I even bought some stuff from AutoZone just in case I ain't have it in there. I'm like, nah, I'm going to have everything. I'm bring the whole tool. I got another toolbox. I got tools on the table back there. It's a junkie back there. But it's all tools. I need to give me one of them toolbox things. But anyway, this is 105, yeah, 105 millimeter, bro. I went stupid when I bought that one. And this sucker right here, you see that wire right there? He gonna hook up right up in. If you can't see it through the bag, but I'm gonna pull out the bag in a minute. But it hook up right there. And you know, I open my stuff up. I've been opening this. I opened it already. You got the gasket in there, and you got some new screws in there. They did me justice. You see how big that wire hole is? I'm gonna show you how small that one is once we take it off. It already looks smaller just looking at it right there. And you know what it is, what I got over here. I'm taking that off. You see how small this is? I mean, to me in reality, when I'm looking at this, I got real big hands. My hands are huge. So if I take my hand and put it on there and it's doing that, I got really big hands. So if I'm able to do that, you know that sucker is big in real life. Like my hands are humongous. Anybody that knows me knows I got really big hands, and I'm able to cover this entire thing with my hand, and I could almost grip it like a basketball. That's it. So just imagine if this was a basketball and the width was a little bit wider. That's what this is. Like I couldn't pick this up, but I could pick up a basketball. That's how big this is. But this one in this box though is even bigger than that. You already know what it is. What it say on there? What I got over here? Okay. We got JLT in there, huh? Oh, I want to show y'all, too, something from my last video. I got to show you something about this. So, matter of fact, in my last video, when I showed you how to install this catch can, this is the way you take it off. It's easy. In reality, all you got to do is turn it. I don't know if I can do this with one hand. It's lefty-tighty, righty-loosey, and it's upside down, so it's the opposite way. You see how I get that? All you got to do is you don't have to take the whole thing out, take the screws out and all that. But on a sketch can, you literally turn this off the bottom. I want to look in here anyway. I want to see if I caught anything. And it's still... Oh, it's got a little bit in there. Look at it. Look at it. I'm already saving my motor. Do you see that? Already. There's something in there. So all these people that got these 392, mine, I just got over 1,000 miles on mine. And I got a little bit in there. And I just put this on. Literally. Just put this on. And I already got some in here. So I probably put about maybe 200 or 300 miles on my car. And that right there is in there. Now I'm not going to empty this because I want to clean it all out and all that good stuff when I get ready to do it. So I'm just going to go ahead and reinstall this back on. And righty tighty, left loose. My bad. I'm trying to figure this out and try to do it all with one hand. I don't want to strip the screws out. Yeah, it's good now. Now you can just kind of. Matter of fact, I'm gonna do this with my right hand. It'll probably be a little quicker and easy. I'm gonna make this take all day because I know my video yesterday. See, I'm doing both of these videos in the same day because I know I can do this quick. So that's tight. yeah. I just get about hand tight. You don't gotta go retarded. Like, I got a gorilla hand. Like I told you, my hands are big. So if I grip that and turn it too much, I could probably break it. But anyway, that's how you do that. And you see I already got oil in there. Or, you know, oil fuel mixture that could have came straight from back here. This is supposed to be like its own catch can for the motor, but it's not as good. So you got two, basically. You're going to have one here, and it's going to come down that line and come into here. So it's two of them. You got both of them, basically. So it's going to do that, bam. It's already got some in there. And then it's not going to send anything back this way because obviously you have two. Now, I'm going to take this off in the future when I get ready to do something else. And then you'll be able to see how this works on here. If there's anything in here, we'll see it. You know, it's probably kind of wet because obviously, you know, I didn't put this on automatically when I had the car. I already had put on probably a good 980 something miles by the time I put this on here. So now it's over 1,000 and I got this on here. So we're going to see in the future, but that's irrelevant right now because we're going to do this stuff over here. And this isn't going to take me longer than an hour to do it. It'll probably take me about maybe 40 minutes and I have all this put together. But first thing I'm going to do, I like to tell people what I'm going to do. I'm going to take this bolt out right here. And I'm going to do this the right way because I'm not just going to unsnap it from over here and pull this stuff and say, fuck it. Well, I might do it that way. I'm not going to hold you. I might just go ahead and pull this. And I'm going to loosen this one too, just to be on the safe side. I got a flathead over there. I'm not even going to use, you know, a drill. And zip. I'm just going to use the flathead, turn it. I'm going to use the flathead, turn that. And then I'm going to pull this hose off of here. Because that's going to go in the new one. Matter of fact, I can probably get it off right now with one hand. So that's already off. So all I got to do is unscrew, unscrew, unscrew. And I'm going to pull this whole box right out of here because it's nothing but something back here snapping it in. It's going to give it a good tug. It's going to come right out of there. And so next time you see it, only thing's going to be on here is the throttle body. And all this will be out at one time. And this is brand new. It only has 1,100 miles on the basic. So that is a really good thing. And I'm not going to sell it. I'm literally going to take this out and put it in this box. But I'm going to show you a step that I'm going to do after taking this out. It's a step that I'm going to do with the taillight. There's actually a cap back there. And I'm going to take that cap out so I get straight flow. And I'll show you why once I take this out. Give me a second. So, as y'all can see, it's out of there. And all you left with is this small throttle body, which you can look in there and see how that goes up like that. And I'm going to show you the other one because it's not going to be like this. It's going to be wide open, all of this. You'll see when I put the other one in. And I'm going to take them screws out. I'm actually going to pull everything off now. Let me explain something to you though. This here and them other screws on here, focus in. Oh, you gotta take the map sensor. That was real easy. The map sensor, the little sensor that goes in there is right here. It just sticks in and you turn it a certain way with that little hook thing and it pushes in kind of like that. And you push it in there and let that O-ring right there seat. Once the O-ring sink, it's good. But you want to pull it out. And I pulled it out while I was still attached to that right there. And I was thinking, oh, I'll just leave it there. But I said, no, I don't want it to get messed up. So I'm going to sit over here with this bolt. And this bolt is an 8. You can see it's an 8. So I went and got an 8 with an extension. But I didn't need the extension. I just put that 8 on the ratchet. And I unscrewed it because it was right there. And you can see it was in there. And it was just, you know, kind of, if I can get it in there, looking at the camera, it was just holding in like that. Matter of fact, I'm gonna leave it right there till I get done. And I used the 8. Then I said forget it because the other things were 8 on there too. Instead of using the screwdriver, I went ahead and just untighten them all the way, loosen them all the way, and pulled it on out. Didn't take that much effort. But now I'm gonna go ahead and get them 4 screws out and pull that that plug off of there. And next time you see it, that's gonna be gone. All right, now with a little bit of blood, sweat, and tears, because that was a beast getting off. I'm gonna hold you. Don't get too forceful with that because you end up breaking it. But this is the little thing that goes in there, and those clamps, they like really suck. But I got it off, so, and it goes right there, and it just clips onto that little piece and it pushes in. But you know, the other one has it. But I want you to see how it looks on the inside compared to the other one. Oh my god, Oh my God. I can see it. I know you probably can't, but I can see that joker. That mug is big. No, I'm just playing. But it is. It's pretty big. It's huge compared to that little bitty hole. You got that big giant thing finna go under now. So, tell you what, I might go ahead and put this on. Then I'll show you a trick with this box that I'm gonna put on here after that. So, next time you see this, it's gonna literally be on the car right there. All right, now. I want y'all to see though, if it focus in on it. You see that thing right there? 102 millimeters. So it wasn't 105, it's 102 millimeters. That's gonna get slapped on there. Like, boom, give me that air. Yeah, I just wanted to show y'all that real quick before I put it on the car so y'all can read it in a week basically and be like, dang, you got 102. I ain't never seen. Yeah, but I got one, cause you see it right there. You see how big the hole is? Jesus Christ, that mug gonna be breathing. All right, so I'm gonna put it on there, get back at you. All right, so now I have the new throttle body in there. And I put this gasket on here because it came with one. It's blue, it kind of throw the engine off a little bit, but I mean, it already had like an O-ring in there, but I know this gasket came with it for a reason. So I went ahead and put it back there. The blue kind of throws it off. But hopefully my filter's blue so they kind of go together. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, it was kind of easy. I did have to pull my drill out and I turned it all the way down. And I pulled my drill out because I was using my Allen wrench key thing on there. So I could put those in there because they recess. So this one down here especially, it goes all the way inside there. And it holds it back. And it's on the firm. And I'm going to give you a comparison here in a minute. Because as you see, it's a real big opening. It's on there, like that's not going anywhere. I'm moving the car. And this is the other one. So let's look at this one compared to that one. And yeah, the one behind it probably could swallow this one. I think this is like an 84 or 80 or something. And that's 102. So that's humongous. All the air you finna just suck in, it's ridiculous. Anyway, I put this in a box because I always keep everything this stock. I'm gonna actually go ahead wrapping in this paper and I'm gonna tell you what I'm gonna do next. I'm just gonna kind of clean this up and I'm gonna show you something I'm gonna do back there, but let me get this stuff wrapped up and put to the side so I can save it for when I trade the car back in, because you know I'm gonna trade it in, but I'm gonna leave it on there and I'm gonna give them that back, or I might just take that off, I don't know. Because that sucker was high. All right, so I'm gonna show y'all what I was doing here. I'm trying my flash on. And I was gonna do it, and then I started thinking, like, it's cold as hell outside, obviously. You see, they go 5-0 over there, you know, little RT on there, or whatever. Can't see it for real, but it's him. Anyway, it's gonna start snowing. So I was gonna go ahead, and that cap that's right there, I was gonna take it out. You can see it real good right there. You see that cap back there? You can take it out. It's inside of this right here, it's actually a little bolt. You take off on this side and there's one on the other side, it's really hard to get to, and you pull that sucker out, and the JLT series 2 actually has a hole for it to go right into it and give you all that air. But for now, I'm not going to utilize that yet, not while it's cold. So when it gets hotter out, I'm going to open all this back up, take this thing off, it won't be that hard, and pull the thing up, and I'm going to pull that out, and then I'm going to do it in the summertime, because I really don't want to get that much cold air in, because it's going to be a lot. I don't know if it's a good or bad thing. I guess comment and let me know if you think it's a bad idea. All right. Let me get to pulling this JLT out, and I'm going to show you how it's going to set up. All right. So this thing right here came off in there. It's still on there, but you need to put that on here. So basically, I'm gonna take a screwdriver right here, dirty old screwdriver, put it on there, take that off, and I'm gonna put that on there, and then I'm gonna slide it down because I just had it all the way down. I was like, why is this sitting? Duh. Anyway, let me go ahead and do that, and I'll get right back at you. Real simple, nice and easy, and breezy. It moves around a lot more on there. Now you see what that looks like without it. So if yours doesn't look like that when you pull it up, you got a problem. Anyway. I'm finna do this hard thing of jamming this big gigantic thing in this liberty hole. That's what she said. All right, so now you got that big thing in there, and I was gonna put that piece on with that, but it just didn't fit. So I used it by itself and tightened it down, and it's pretty well in there. Like, it's not gonna move unless somebody pulls it up from the back, but who's gonna open up your hood to do that? Nobody. So I'm gonna take this and keep that with that. Then now we're gonna stick this thing here, and it comes with like some stuff in there I'm gonna look at, and that goes on there. Now look, literally it's still daylight out. It's about almost 4 o'clock. So I've been out here 30 minutes and I've done that, and I'm about to be finished with this in a couple of seconds because I didn't do the other part. And you see that hole literally goes right to my headlight. So that's why in the summertime I said I'm gonna take it off, and I can literally probably just put an air filter out and I can still grab this and I can work on this with just pulling the filter out and get this off, and I could do this in the summer. But I don't want to do it now, but I can do it whenever I want because the hole is so big, it's ridiculous. I can do it whenever I want without even taking that bolt out and trying to smash this thing in there. I ain't got to do none of that. But that's where the air comes from, basically. And you're going to get some from the front because it's going to come through those little holes in the grill. All right, but I'm going to go ahead and try to assemble this. Next time you see me, it'll be together. So, since I have a bigger throttle body, I had to go to the directions because they send you this to go in between here. And obviously, that hole on that side is not big enough. If both sides were that big, I'd be in the money. But you're dealing with that on that side, which is extremely small. It's not going to work. So I said, I'm going to take this and go to either Home Depot or Walmart. Find one that is big like this on this side all the way around. And I'm gonna have to get some clamps that's about that big on both sides. I can't do any clamps that are this size. These are way too small. I literally need bigger ones because that throttle body is huge. I might have been able to use this if I had like a 90 millimeter or even an 85 or 84, but with that big sun gun right there, this ain't gonna work. So yeah, I am gonna lose daylight, but so would I rather do it right than do it wrong. So I'm gonna go ahead and go up to AutoZone and stuff and get one. I was gonna try to put this one on there and just kind of jimmy rig it on there so I could drive it, but that ain't gonna work because guess what, it has a thing for the map sensor or whatever sensor it's called right there, and I already have it over here, so you can't have two, you can only have one. So that's in the box, just like that's gonna be in the box too. Actually, all of that is in the box. Take off. And I'm gonna put that in the box. And I'm gonna run up here and go get it. And I'll probably finish the video. Probably turn the headlights on the car, but I'll get it. Alright, see ya soon. You probably see me come right back. I'm literally gonna be like boom bam and I'm gonna be back doing this. Alright, but when you see it, that'll probably be connected because I'm just gonna come in and do it. And then I start talking from there. Oh, and my air filter, they gave me a red one. I would rather did a blue one. But anyway, I got a gigantic, oh my God, type air filter that goes on there. You, my Jesus. Anyway, I hate doing my videos that way, but it's, yeah, huge. Anyway, see y'all in a second. All right, guys, as you can see, it got late. Got 5-0 out here with the lights on. And my engine bay is dark. I got a headlight on my head so I can see what I'm doing, but you can see it too. So I got the throttle body and this thing here. This is a big giant scoop. So that's the old one. Well, old. I had to go to Home Depot to get it, and everybody's acting like they was retarded, so I went down there and got it. This is a plumbing hose, but it serves the same purpose as this here. That's just fancy, and it got that on there for JLT Performance. But this is big enough to fit on my throttle body because it fits over this, and I tighten it down. So I have to tighten that one all the way down. And this actually fits inside of this one, actually. It fits inside. But I'm gonna go ahead and put this on there and I'm gonna show you what it looks like. I mean, it's gonna be kind of crazy because that thing is humongous, but it's 4 inches wide. So that means that this is 4 inches wide too. Well, you can't see in there now, but it's 4 inches wide. That's crazy. My exhaust is even 4 inches. My exhaust is 3 inches. Jesus Christ. Anyway, next when you see it again, it'll be on there, hopefully. All right, guys, I got it on now. And as you can see, you know, it ain't letting me use my phone thing no more. My battery running dead. So I kind of just put this on there because it came with a sticker and I want to stick it on my car, but I actually put that sticker on there, as you can see. And that's it, JLT. Took me till it got dark outside, but I had to go to Home Depot and get this piece right here. It's a 4-inch plumber pipe that works the same as this. So, I mean, that's because I put that throttle body on there. It took me a little bit longer. It's 102mm. So, yeah, it's like that. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this away. And you know what the time it is. You know what I do when I come around, man. Sit over there on my table. Got him over here. How he sound. All right. So, oh man, let's get this box out the way. It's got my old stuff in it. Gotta find somewhere to put all my little old stuff that came off. You know, I don't sell it. I put it back on. Take my stuff back off. So all that, I put on something else. I sell that for more than I sell the stock. So, but like I said, you know what time it is. 50 block. Let's go, nigga. Oh man, damn. I feel hella stupid because the car probably ain't gonna do it. Let's see. Never mind, he don't get to it. I'm about to go in there and start it myself. I feel hella stupid. Anyway, I might cut that out. I might not, because it's funny. Alright, so we're gonna get in here. I might be running low on gas. That's probably what it is. Holy shit.
Woo hoo hoo hoo! Yeah. God dang. Boy, oh boy. You can hear that shit? Oh yeah, we got some rocks. Woo, that sucker is sucking, sucker. Snap, crackle, and pop in this motherfucking goddamn room.
All right, guys, it's a whole new day. I'm up in 5-0. I got me a mask. Yeah, I got me a mask. I'm about to go to the doctor real quick. A dentist appointment. And as you can see in the video, because I didn't make an outro, that thing got a lot of power ever since I put the throttle body and all that stuff on there. I ain't started 5-0 in a minute, you hear him? It been 3 days, he ain't been started. He trying not to start up on me, but I got a starter in there to put on him. And I got a couple of things I'm gonna do to this car too. Kinda in a rush, but you know with a Hemi, you wanna let it run for a minute. So I'm gonna let it run for just a couple of seconds before I pull off. Yeah, but basically, it's got a lot of power. I'm gonna put my actual drive around in another video. I'm gonna make a whole separate video and put my reaction video, basically like a reaction to having it on the first day. It was all the same night. This video is really long already. It's like over 20 minutes, and I was like, well, I'm just gonna cut it down because I really wanted to be like 15, but I ran into a couple of problems, like with the throttle body being so big, I had to go to Home Depot and get a piece to go in the middle because the other piece wasn't big enough. Obviously, if you was watching the video, you seen it in there. But yep, I said it's gonna be the end of it. Get back at you in the next one. Cute outro.
Hell yes, that 50th edition.
Yeah, it's 50, AKA Ferrari F50. Break it down. I got a lot of living to do before I die, and I ain't got time to waste. Let's make it. You say you a gangster, but you never pop none. You say you a wankster, and you need to stop frontin'. You ain't a friend of mine, you ain't no kin of mine. What makes you think that I'ma run up on you?